The car I'd inherited for nothing. It was literally on its last moments. But of course, in those days, you made things go. You didn't chuck everything. But the tires we had, I was inexperienced about long cross-country trips. The tires we had were giving way. As I recall, in the first 500 miles, we had upward of 10 flats. So it became a routine. We'd get the sudden pop. I'd pull off to the right, Wilson would get his collecting bag, and I'll change the tire. And finally, on the return trip, I called my parents collect from Salt Lake City, and I said, we're not going to make it. I've got to buy four tires. And you bought recaps in those days for $8 a piece. But, you know, this was close to 50 bucks that we needed. And calling my parents, who were themselves rather destitute, was the embarrassment of my life. But we made it back as a consequence. One of the highlights of the trip was we had just gone through the desert country. And we hadn't had a shower in a few days. We were feeling pretty grubby and hungry and stopped at the edge of the road, bought some shrimp. This was in Louisiana. And we're cooking them on our Coleman stove at the side of the road. And a man comes up to us carrying a dead snake and said, what is this one? And Wilson, who was an amateur herpetologist, gave this long lecture about the snake. And this guy was sitting down and listening. And he said, where are you guys headed for? And I said, I don't know, as far as we can before we go to sleep. He says, where do you stay? I said, we stay outdoors in a cot. He says, you want to sleep in a motel? He was the motel owner. We were parked right in front of it, and we got this wonderful free night in the motel. I remember standing under the shower for 2 hours. I think it probably clogged the system. But Wilson's knowledge of snakes paid off.